They one of them said, so and so doesn't know how to recite the Quran. I've heard people say, well, Sheikh Ibn Baz doesn't know how to recite the Quran. There is this Dubandi misguided person in Syria, is in Turkey. He says, Sheikh Ibn Baz and Albani don't know how to recite the Quran. Then, alhamdulillah, a brother exposed this individual. He himself doesn't know how to recite the Quran. Yes, why? When they say, because when you bring a scroll of Quran and listen to me or listen to anyone, they can tell you it's not the way it should be recited in the perfect way, yes? But even that some ulama said ghulu, extreme. You don't have to say ghunna, you know, iqlab, you know, like some people say a'u, a'. You have to mention a, ta'da haqqa, and so on. Some scholars said there's no need of that. This came after, some scholars said no, how, that's how the Arabs spoke. Regardless, the point here is that these one of people of innovation guys are utilizing that to turn the people away from the truth. Alhamdulillah, in our masjid, we have huffad, people that memorize the Quran, five of them. And they teach the Quran, I don't teach the Quran. You know, alhamdulillah, I know how to recite, alhamdulillah. Maybe out for, I can make mistakes, no doubt about that. Even when I'm reading, sometimes your eyes trick you, no doubt about it. It can happen to anyone, you understand? Even this person who is mocking Uthman Farooq, himself, you know, this Dubandi guy, he himself, he said, he said, Salat al-Jama'ah, it's Salat al-Jumu'ah. You understand? So, yeah, not al-Jama'ah. Yeah, khutbat al-Jama'ah. He said, khutbat al-Jama'ah. No, khutbat Salat al-Jumu'ah. He's mocking the brother. He said, Fatha, laysa dhamma. Masha, you're mocking him? Because I never, alhamdulillah, sit down in front of camera, try to correct people in recitation. You know, because even if you know how to recite the Quran, but your aqeedah is corrupted, that will not benefit you. Abu Jahl in you, you know, if you give a Quran, you know how to recite it. You know? There's extreme Sufis that have the imams mutqin in qira'ah. That did not benefit them. That's what Allah said. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ Do they not reflect upon the Qur'an? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُ آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ Allah sent on the Qur'an to reflect upon it. And so Shaykh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah said, some people have ghulu in this recitation. So he's more focusing on ghunna, alhamdulillah. But he's not even reflecting upon what is the meaning of alhamdulillah. He's focusing on pronouncing ha, you know, al-meem, al-dal, you know. He's more focusing on makharij al-huruf than reflecting upon what is the meaning of alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. That doesn't mean we should not try to correct our recitation, try to, but it's not conditional for every day to do that. You know, if you're going to teach people Quran, yes, to be mutqin ahsan. Barakallahu feekum. So I had to clarify that, alhamdulillah, because I've noticed people with innovation misguidance, they try to utilize this to turn people away from the people of the truth. Huh? May Allah bless you, akhi. The khawarij, they will know for Quran. Lakin, la yatajawazu hanajirahum. Doesn't know go, he knows, akhi. Huh? Akhi. One of the best teachers of Quran, what was his name? Abdurrahman bin Muljim. Abdurrahman bin Muljim, he's the person, Ibn Khattab said to Amr ibn al-As, he said, I'll let this person to come to you, even though I want him to stay with me to teach the Quran to the people. But I'm giving him to you to teach the Quran. He was a teacher of the Quran. What did he do? He killed Ali bin Abi Talib. So he's makharij al-huruf, al-dad. والعين والغين والقاف والكاف did not benefit him. Subhanallah. You see? So, and the worst thing I ask that these Dubandis, the Aqidah is corrupted. I'm not talking about every Dubandi, some layman come to speak to me. But Dubandi Aqidah, Ash'ari Aqidah, so the Aqidah of the Salaf al-Salih. And they say he mock Ibn Taymiyyah. I don't mock Imam al-Nawawi. Imam al-Nawawi is big Imam, rahimahu ta'ala. But he has mistakes. But this Muqallidah, they blind follow any scholar. We don't blind follow them. But Imam al-Nawawi, big scholars, refused his mistakes, but we love him. He has his special status. Likewise, Al-Hafid Ibn Hajj al-Asqalani, may Allah have mercy upon him. They were not Asha'ira. Yes, they felt some, they had some mistakes. There's no shamsi saying that, because I'm no one in comparison to them. The ulama, our ulama, correct them. May Allah have mercy upon them. And we're not like, we are not like Haddadiyya, those who say, may burn their books and so on. No. The Ummah benefit from their works. May Allah have mercy upon them. Nawawi, Ibn Hajj al-Asqalani. May Allah have mercy upon them. May Allah forgive them. And may Allah have mercy upon us and our parents and our loved ones. May Allah bless you, my brothers and sisters. I love you for the sake of Allah. May Allah Jalla wa Ala unite us in Jannat Firdaus. May Allah bless you. I have to go. Hayyakum Allah. I can't take the mics with me, man. I would love to say.